Open the chat. Can you go on the stream and tell me if you can hear the music? It should just be like faint in the background. It shouldn't be too loud. You should be able to hear me. Alright. Barely. Should I put a little bit more? I'm trying to get it to where you can hear it, but not like where it's overbearing. Is that good? Okay, cool. Whatever. Alrighty. So, here we have a design that we're going to be doing today. We're going to be doing a design for James Melton. If you guys don't remember, he sent a bunch of canvases over. And yeah, this one is for his son. I asked him what, you know, he would want painted, and he said his son was really into the Cars movie, or movies. So I drew up Lightning McQueen here, and we're going to go ahead and do Lightning McQueen. We're gonna do them airbrush style with some candy, some pearl paint. Yeah, so let's move on over to this camera and we'll get started. What's up, Eric Todd? How's it going, man? That's working over there. Alright, so before we get started, I'm just gonna start by mixing up some of this candy paints. Alright, so I'm gonna use the matte clear for this, just so that it all dries the same, so the Createx colors and the candy all dries kind of matte, and then I'll lay a gloss clear before we send it out. So, but anyway, we're gonna start off by mixing some of this candy in this bottle here. We got a clean Createx bottle. I've ordered bottles for mixing up candy that don't have a spout, or that have a squirter that attaches on the top, you know. But I've ordered some of those. And we're going to be using those, but for the meantime, I'll use this one today just so that we can go ahead and get it going. So I'm just shaking this up a little bit, make sure there's nothing sitting in there, but open it. And the reason we want to mix this up first is because it takes it about 10 minutes to really kind of settle in and mix in together. So yeah, go ahead and give that a little bit of time to do its thing. So, and then we have 4011 reducer now in the bottle. You know, so we're going to be using 4011 reducer. We're going to be using Blood Red Candy 2.0. And the matte UVLS clear, like I've already said. So go ahead and put some of this clear in here. And I don't think we'll need much, but we'll just do a little bit like that. That's probably more than enough. Close that back up. Back up there. Get my hands cleaned off of this. Cool. So we have, you guys can see that, not that much clear in there. Right. And then we're just gonna mix in some of this blood red. Now, there is no particular amount that you have to put in there. Again, it all depends on how thick or how dark you want your red coat to look. Be careful of getting this on your hands. As you can see, it will stain right away, so don't do that. But in our case, we're going to throw a good little amount in there. Like so. I'm going to try to use this little thing there to mix it. We'll probably do this. And then we're going to let this sit for a minute. It's all mixing in there. Alright, so now we're gonna let that red candy kind of just sit off to the side there while we work on this. So I've kind of drawn it out, as you can see, and what I'm gonna do now is kind of tape off the main body of Lightning McQueen here. The reason we want to do this is because we want to keep the silver and the candy inside of the Lightning McQueen body, so luckily he's pretty much straight, so it shouldn't take that long. What's up, James Melton? How's it going? Nice, man, nice. It was nice here for a second outside, and then it really just got nasty outside. What's up, Justin Varn? How's it going? He left now. Oh, okay. Enough. All right. Sweet. Up, what camera am I using? I'm using two Logitech cameras at the moment. They're the 1080p ones. Also, the lights came in. Rolling with the new lights now. Oh snap! I don't know if you guys noticed, there's no crazy glare on the canvas. It's staying nice and bright and even. And yeah, hopefully all our lighting problems are behind me. Baby, you want to do me a favor? Can you bring me that silver helmet again? Just so I could show them that you could see the silver now. Looks like a whole different kind of silver, doesn't it? Look. I suck at getting it in the right spot, but thank you, babe. Yeah, hopefully the lighting is behind. So the whole idea with this was to paint the Lightning McQueen for his son, also at the same time start using some of these Createx products so we can get used to them and check them out, and you guys can check them out with me, but also at the same time give something that James could, you know, go and look at that he'd be like, oh dang, you know. Stephanie Calono. Hola. Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Jesse Walker. Something. Something. All right, cool. Yeah, Jesse, go ahead, man. I mean, shit, you never know. Maybe you got all the skills to also get a package. I wouldn't put all my beans in that basket, but, you know, you never know. Never say never. Always dream big. Do it, bro. If you think you can get a package, do it.
Curved. All right, I guess maybe I should take up the lights. Maybe the lights.
What's up, BC Airbrush? Oh, you haven't missed anything yet, dude. We just started. I just started off by mixing up a little bit of candy, and then we're letting it sit while I do the taping off of this body for this Lightning McQueen here. So we're gonna put some silver down. We're gonna shade it in. What's up, Evan? Hopefully you enjoy this painting, guy. Cool. So now that we got that all taped up, should the tape is laying down. Alright. So I'm going to start off. I'll take the towel in here. Take a little bit of pearl silver. Alright, we're gonna start off with pearl silver here. That's cool, man. You cannot seem to get rid of the pencil. What do you mean you can't get rid of the pencil? Like the pencil drawing? So, on metal. Like direct to metal or like on a car. Usually I try not to do that many pencil marks, and if I do, I usually, where's it? It's right here. I was just using it. That's where this comes in handy. Some Friskit. Right, you use some Friskit. I cover the area in Friskit, draw it on the Friskit, then cut it out and stuff like that, or you know, transfer it in some kind of way. Also, if you must insist on using a pencil, get yourself a charcoal pencil. So charcoal pencils, it's really light, like, you know, just trace it really light. But when you're working with a charcoal pencil, most of the time, as soon as you get close to where the line is supposed to be, it blows away the charcoal off of the surface. So you don't end up with lines. And charcoal is real easy to wipe off. So. But I'm going to take some pearl silver. Right, I'm just going to put a little bit in there. I'm going to take the 4011. I'm just going to drop a little bit in there. Put the lid on. I'm gonna shake it up real good. What panel are you airbrushing? This is a canvas panel. I like to do most of my illustrations on canvas. If I had access to cheap steel or something, I would probably use steel panels as well, but yeah, I don't. So what we're gonna do is lay down a nice layer of silver over all the red parts. Here you can see the numbers and stuff, and we might put a light coat over that before we put yellow and whatnot, but we're gonna try to avoid that altogether. And I might just come back in with the illustration yellow, so we'll see, but we'll get to that when we get there. For now, I'm just gonna start off with the silver, and it's just the pearl silver. So I don't know how well it's going to show on camera, to be honest. Oh, okay. Cool. I need to make sure that lid is not clogged. Where did it fly to is the other question. I'm not in here somewhere. Oh well. I'll have to find it. So we're just gonna cover this whole thing. Probably gonna do a couple coats. Probably need to turn up the pressure a little bit. Let me find that lid. Airbrush without a lid is like just accident waiting to happen. There it is. Alright. Yeah, that's stupid. The vent hole is clogged, of course. This little vent hole, it seems like it's pointless, but it'll stop paint from flowing, and just like that, if you back flush, it'll create pressure and shoot off. So you gotta make sure that little hole is always clear. It's usually rare that it gets paint in it, but sometimes. Alright, there we go. Again, this probably won't show very well on stream. But right away it gets a really shiny effect. Turning gray a little bit gray. A little bit harder to see, but they're still there. Alright. I've got all that in there. It's pretty silver. Put that back over there. We're going to take the velocity and we are going to mix up some black in here. And we're going to kind of shade it in. We're going to maybe make some of the details out. And why not? Let's treat ourselves. Let's use the wicked jet black. What's up, Luan13? Carbon paper or graphite paper? The only problem I've ever had with using like the transfer paper like that is that sometimes it's bleed. Like it bleeds like with a you know, with a clear coat or anything you put over the top of it, sometimes it runs. That's kinda what the gist of it is. So this is the Wicked Jet Black. And we're gonna take some of this. Right, and we're gonna mix it a little bit because we're gonna need it for quite a few things. I'll throw some 4011 in there. Probably about 3 parts paint, 1 part reducer is what I'm going for right now. Manuel Torres. We're not really spraying like super high amounts of paint, so not really, no. There's, we have a window open. Shents, how do you decide what color orders or sequence? So for this particular piece, because we are spraying the candy, it's like spraying a base coat, clear coat. So this is the base coat, and then in between we're gonna lay some artwork, which is what I'm about to do, and then we're gonna lay the clear coat, which would be the candy coat, over this, which is gonna give everything a red, you know, look. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. So here we go. We got the black all mixed up. So, just starting off, let me pick up the reference here. Start off right here with his mouth area. And we're basically gonna do the painting like if we were gonna do it in black and white. So I'm just gonna start off by building up kind of his mouth shadows. Shadow coming down right here. Right, working off the reference. Track of these, we might want to imprint them a little bit. Right there. What's up, Nick? I think you're going to like the candies. Oh, yeah, yeah. I was confused. Those are candies. Like, what candies? Get that in there. Yeah, that's typical me, man. I'm just like, what are you talking about? Hmm? Oh, yeah. You ever use them? No, this will be my first time trying them out, so it's a learning experience on stream. I'm just following the instructions right now, which it says to kind of give them a while to sit, and I can see that it already, like, it's kind of settling in there. So I'm just kind of letting it sit while I get all this detail in, and then we're going to come back in and spray them in there. Back and tape these off and actually do these in yellow candy. Now that I'm thinking about it. Oh, I should do. So I'll mix up a little bit of yellow candy after I'm done doing this, and that could sit while we spray the red. Ronald, hola, hola. How do I make the thin lines? Jeez. It's hard to explain. But the airbrush, it's all about how far like you are from the surface and how far you pull back on the trigger. You always want to hold down. Getting fine lines means you're barely like away from the surface and you're also barely pulling on the trigger. And that's how you'll get those fine little lines. You can get them really, really fine if you try. Yeah, it's just all practice, really. But anyway, I think we got most of that in there. There is a design on this hood, too, so maybe we pick this hood in there. So I'm gonna let that dry for a second. I'm gonna take another little bottle. Alright. And I'm just gonna mix up just a little bit of that yellow candy. What is this? Lemon yellow. We can let that sit while we spray the red. And I'm just gonna mix up just a tiny bit because we only need like a little tiny bit. So that's honestly probably more than enough, but yeah, having not thick paint helps, but you could also get around that by having a bigger needle, so you can spray pretty thick paint with a 0.5 and still get pretty thin lines. But yeah, generally, if you want to get really thin lines, really precise lines, you want to make sure your paint's like really thin, you're working with low pressure, and yeah, your finger control has to be pretty precise. I mean, you really make these things stick on there. It's like doing science experiments over here. What are we doing, huh? We're making up yellow potion number 3. And over here we had monkey's blood that we're gonna use to create the ultimate piece of art. Alright, so we're gonna put that yellow set aside. And let's give this a good old tape test. Right down right here. Seems to be good enough for tape. Let's try to get this taped up here. Now, my theory is that the yellow won't go over the red. So we're gonna spray the red first, and then we're gonna uncover the yellow parts and spray a little yellow candy. And hopefully my theory is correct, and we don't get a whole bunch of, you know, either orange or a bunch of yellow over the red. What's up, James Meltzer? It's awesome. It's not done yet. Hold on. Hold on, James. We're getting there, man. But yes, hopefully it will be awesome when we are finished. That is the goal. What type of tape is that? It's masking tape. Please tell me you know what masking tape is. It's not special. And what is this? 3M general usage. Solid sheet or just regular tape? It's just regular tape. What just happened? It just gave a notification, but I don't see the notification. Yeah, no, it's just regular tape, man. I should be a troll and be like, yo, this is special tape made especially for candy. You can't find it. Got it all. Oh, I got a new member. Who's the new member? Oh man, see, I need to pull up the YouTube. Huh? Oh, James. Oh, sick. Thank you, James. See, this is why having the YouTube chat is helpful. This thing doesn't relay the important stuff like that. They slacken. Alright. Cool. So now I'm gonna take the revolution here. Take out that reducer. You too? What's up, Dennis? Oh yeah, look at James getting down with the skulls right away, hell yeah. So here, I'm going to take some of our candy we mixed up. Right, I'm going to dump it. Not dump it, we're going to put some into our revolution here. And yeah, I don't think that needs any reduction at all. It is actually quite watery once it's been sittering for a little bit. A little test spray. Alright, wait a second. Thank you. Interesting. Cool. Anyway, let's start filling it in here. And we're just going to go ahead and fill it in. And I'm going to do a couple little coats. I'm going to do light coats. So we're going to build it up lightly. We're not going to do heavy coats. How do I not get overspray? Oh, we have this nice tape all the way around. I don't know. Is the tape not visible on the camera? Airbrush kits and paints. Now, I don't know. I would say Amazon is probably the best place. If you get an Amazon Prime membership, and you go on Amazon, and the only reason I say that is because you'll get the next, like, you know, and a lot of times, a lot of stuff's like next day or 2 days. And it doesn't cost you any extra. It's like, you know, that's what I would say. But if you don't live in the US, then I don't know. I would say go with your local art store. Oh, look, we forgot to cut that piece off right there. I'm a big fan of Hobby Lobby, not gonna lie. Like, it's a love-hate relationship. I hate that they sell all the home decor stuff, but I love that they sell art supplies. So it's love-hate. Maybe talking about how nice and clean your walls are. Do you ever get paint lift when backmasking? Yeah, sometimes. That's why I did that paint check just a second, the tape check. Honestly, some of this might pull off when I pull the tape off. We'll see. We'll see, son. But I taped over pencil lines, so I guess it won't really matter. We're also working really light. I don't know if you guys can tell. I'm building up really light coats. So we're not, like, making clouds in here. You know? We're not trying to spray as much paint as possible. I have no problem working a little bit slower and building it up. A lot of people trip out on that, I guess. I don't know. And just going back and getting it in there. And it is really super transparent, so you could see, I don't know if you could tell on the camera or not, but you could see that it's like really shifting with every coat I give it. Just a little more red. You could see a little bit of overspray coming off, but it's not much. And we ran through that red. I can just throw a little bit more. That's why I mixed up extra. You lay some inner coat over the top. Yeah. I've never laid inner coat on pieces of art, but if you're working on a vehicle, yeah. But also, if you're having paint lift, you're having problems with your paint adhering, which could be another problem all entirely. Now it's not starting to change. That's when you know the candy is starting to get uniform. Is when you start spraying it and you don't see any more change in the color. That means you've reached the full depth of that candy. I mean, you could keep layering it and layering it, but I mean, from here the returns are diminishing on your layers, right? It's not really going to get any more red than the red that's there. And you can see our lines came through. Our shading came through. I don't know how well it shows on stream, but you kind of see that shimmering of the pearl that we laid. You can see that shimmering through just a tad bit and just nice enough. And I'm sure once we put some shiny gloss clear and put a light on it, it'll probably be really shimmery. There you go. Our first candy application, there you go. Simple enough. I'm gonna make sure to run some 4011 reducer in this. Gonna rinse it out with that. Use intercoat between layers for your flames? Man, that's a lot of extra spraying for no reason. So I don't think you need intercoat on flames. But we'll see. I'm going to make a video on doing a true fire with candy, so we'll see. But I don't think that's necessary. And actually, we'll see right now, because I'm going to bust lay some yellow over this red, and we'll see if the bleed is real or if it's not. So. Anyway, take this off, and we can take this whole back piece off. Especially when you're working on canvas. Yeah, no, I don't use inner coat clear on canvases. It seems a little over the top. Especially on true fire either, I probably wouldn't use it. I'd probably use it once I'm done and spray it over the top of the whole project so that nothing else mixes with it or messes with it. That would seem like the proper application. But anyway, I'm going to take some of this candy yellow I've mixed. It's been sitting for a minute. I'm there. See it coming in. Yeah, it's nice. I just build it up. Yeah, my theory is correct. The yellow is not really showing up over the red. So, yeah, but it's not bleeding. I just laid yellow over the red. Or is it? Look, it's starting to bleed. No, it's not. Like I said, I don't know. We're gonna try it. We'll experiment with it. But all the times I've applied fire, I've never, for one, used candy. I've always applied it just, you know, using paint, and it always comes out great, you know, using transparent colors. And for two, I don't know, usually it just gets clear coated afterwards. No inner coat, no. I laid the Createx, you saw me lay the silver, and then you saw me tape this up, and you saw me pull it up, and it's not still there. What's up, Dan Grove? How's it going? Willis y Medina, ¿qué tal? ¿Qué onda? ¿A qué presión de aire? Estamos como a 30 libras ahorita. Oh, man. Fully built. I don't think it's not really changing colors anymore. Nice and bright yellow. Yeah, it's not bleeding with the red at all, so I don't know. Trying to really go over that red, and this is not, there's no way to get the yellow over the red. It's truly transparent, so the red will overtake the yellow because it's a darker color. So that's the end of that. Using that new paint, yeah, we're trying out the candy colors on this painting here for James's son. Loaded with paints, it should be good for a while. Yeah, I should be good for a while. We're gonna be painting for quite a while. Just rinsing that out from there. Cool. Make sure we got that out. Actually, I just want to leave a little bit of reducer in this cup until after I'm done, and then I could clean these out. Make sure I get all that candy paint out, and I use the Revolution specifically for that reason. Now we're going to take the Velocity and finish kind of shading these in here. Just to do a little bit of shadows over the candy just to really bring some of those out to the forefront. Some of those shadows. Oh yeah, look at that. It looks really nice. I'm tempted to use some white pearl here to kind of bring out the highlights. I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you think that'll look good? I think that'll look good. I'm not caring your guys' opinion. Huh? Okay. Oh. Okay. That changes it. What are you getting? What are you getting? Huh? Oh, okay. Habaneras? Oh. And actually, I just noticed that in the picture, this part over here is like, it goes like orange, and then these have like a red. I mean, it goes like red to orange to yellow, and these have like a red. So I'm just gonna go ahead and we're gonna take that little bit of red candy we mixed. We still have some left. What is it? Oh, nice. You bought the stand? Nice. Yeah, that stand is pretty cool. I'm probably going to get another one. But now that we've loaded up the candy here, see, now we could go in and build up that little bit of orange there. Just lightly lay that. Lightly. I don't know, man. I'm building it on top of the yellow, and it seems to be working just great. You know, it's getting close. It's just where you're spraying. Maybe if you're like spraying in a high humidity area, maybe the paint just takes a little longer to dry, so you need that bleed checker. Some, I don't know, but like, you look at, even left that yellow along the edge of the numbers, and it still looks really good. It didn't bleed or anything. We were able to fade in an orange color using the red candy over the yellow, and it's not really, you know, I'm not really seeing any reason why we would need to lay the bleed checker in between there. Just me, just my personal thoughts. Yeah. Look at that, it's like beautiful in there. Oh, that looks way good. Okay. Okay. Oh yeah, let me flush this up. We don't need any more of that. And I kind of don't want it hanging in my guns longer than it needs to. Let's be honest with you. Still a little bit nervous about the clear more than the candy. I don't want it to harden up and, you know, gum up. Baby, you could just get Pueblo Dragon. All right, so what else do we need? I think that's it for all that. right? I think that's it. Cool. I think we could just take all the tape off. Hopefully our tape held up. For the most part, it has. In some areas where it lifted up, you can see, but we could just touch that up with some white. No biggie. Queen with this candy paint job. Cool. And now we can just freehand in the rest of it. Simple enough, right? What do you guys think? Looks pretty cool. You guys didn't really get the... It has a really nice, like, tone to it. Oh, you know what we forgot? We forgot to put the candy on the wheels, son. Oh. Disgusting. So here's what I'm gonna lay silver. Silver in there, we're gonna let that dry. Cool. Then we are going to focus on this mouth. Oh, my elbow touched the armrest. Oh yeah, look at that. My head is in the way. Oh, sorry guys. Let me get you guys in. I know I got a big ass head. It's okay. I remember watching Cars for the first time and thinking it was weird that they didn't use the headlights as the eyes. And I was like, why didn't they do that? And now it just seems like it was weird for me to think that, because it's normal the other way. Is that weird? Brainwash. Right? I like that movie, it was cool. Yeah, I like the movie Chick. It's actually a pretty cool movie. And I like the whole premise of it, like a learning to get back to your roots, you know what I'm saying? Guy thought he was all hotshot, and then goes into this little town, and all these things happen. So, tape check. Tape check. Tape check is good. Okay. Hey guys, make sure you put inner coat clear down, otherwise your paint will lift up, you know. Absolutely necessary. Oh my gosh. Just lay down. There you go. Thank you. Yeah, this is the Badger Velocity that I'm using right now. Oh, look, I missed. Yeah. Tape check turned out to be just fine. The SOTAR 2020, huh? I still haven't had my hands on one of those yet. I missed it again. It's alright, we can just get that little piece. I still missed. It's alright. Pretty close. All done over there. And I feel like we should put the red in now. Now's a good time. What's up, RC Roof from Switzerland? How's it going? So again, I'm just gonna load up some more of this red. This is blood red candy. now we're going to color in the wheels.
I'm not going to tape these off. I'm just going to go ahead and color them in, just like if I was using my regular paint. Second to dry, and there's a little bit of overspray, but that's fine because we're going to color that in black with the wheels. So what? Grant, message if you need Hulu, Crunchyroll, Sling, Disney Plus, Minecraft, Uplay, Origin, or NordVPN. Nobody message Grant, okay? Don't do that. That sounds like a scam. Right on, RC Root. Thank you, sir. Yeah, imagine those RC bodies that we're about to do with that candy, dude. You just gotta wait for somebody to place an order. I'm gonna find a way to get candies in into their paint job somehow. They could tell me they just want it red. I'm gonna be like, we're gonna put your candy up red. Just cuz, man. Cool. So we got that in there. Can I go ahead and empty this again for the last time? Huh? Good. That's just a weird message. Was it like a real person or is that like a spam? Major sparkle in some of your builds. Oh, you're already using the candies, huh? Well, the candies themselves don't have the sparkle, but yeah, you could lay some nice pearlescent colors underneath, just like we did on this one. And it's crazy because the red looks like it looks deep, even though it's just like red. It does look like a really nice. Profound red is what I would call it. It looks a little bit unusual. Not like the normal red that I would use, for sure. So yeah, we're just gonna set that aside with some reducer in it, and we're gonna continue on with this black. He looks like as if he was airbrushed. I would like to see some more RC bodies too, but I think with everything that's going on,
Huh?
Yeah, because of social distancing, there isn't much RC racing going on, which means there isn't many RC bodies coming into my door at the moment. Way less than normal, for sure. Tape check? Let's do a tape check. Tape check on fresh paint, let's see. Tape check is good. Originally in the movie. No, yeah, nobody is racing right now for sure. So, yeah. You found what? Yeah, that sounds good too. Two dirt oval race cars collecting dust. Aw, man, that sucks. I'm sorry, dude. Surrounded by customers, Lexan projects, huh? If you're surrounded by them, it sounds like you're getting nothing done, man. RC bodies usually come into my building and they leave 2 days later. Or get shipped back out. Maybe at the max 4 days. So nothing ever sits in my place. It can sit when it's finished. So, the masking film, or the frisket, or whatever you want to call it, it really comes in handy on like bigger projects, right? So, if you feel like you're gonna need to mask off a big area, the masking film is great. If you feel like you're gonna have to make a lot of cuts, like this one's really, it's one big piece, so I feel like I could just mask off the outside with tape. But say, like, if I was going to do all the logos and, like, you know, more details in there, then I would probably lay the frisket down, drawn it on the frisket, and then cut out all the individual parts. And that way I could work part by part by taking those pieces off. So it really just depends on the project. Airbrush is that it's hard to get the dry tip off of it needle because of those dang guards. So yeah, kind of wish those guards weren't there, or if they were removable, like just out of the way. I hear people racing on the highway right now. How do you spell year? I just misspelled it, isn't it? Oh yeah, I did misspell it. I'm an idiot. That's why those lines didn't add up. I was like, what's... See? Always follow your lines. L. Really? Oh my gosh. Really? Can we just go pick it up? At least you got cars on your roads. What's up, Fishing the Backwoods? How's it going? Mike Tyson, can you add some happy puns? What the hell am I listening to? That was weird. That's looking real nice. Normal reduction. I'm gonna ask you one time, son. What is normal reduction? No, I just want to know, what do you consider normal? Like, what do you... I'm genuinely interested, what do you consider normal reduction? Because... I guess, yeah, that's about right, but I don't think people understand that milk consistency is like, there's a lot of variable left in saying that. I thought you were going to be like, you know, 3-1, 4-1, something along those lines. It depends on the paint. It depends on the project, depends on the paint. So I don't want to say yes and no, but yes and no. Yeah, I mean, if you always shoot kind of for the same... If you always shoot kind of for the same, I guess it's always about the same. That's kind of what I shoot for. But a lot of times it depends on the project. If I know I'm shooting for more of a gray, I'll reduce the black more, you know. On this particular project, I'm trying to use the black to chisel in detail, so it's a little bit thicker. Not a whole lot thicker, but it is thicker. Thicker than a normal run, and that's why I'm having a little bit of trouble getting it through there, but this airbrush does have a really fine needle, so it's not a worry. My head's not in the way, is it? Thank you. Yeah, the red here and yellow are candies over a silver pearl. Smoking Torres? What? Tires? On canvas? Interesting. What? Yeah, this is canvas. Looking pretty darn good. So a couple corrections before we continue on. I'm gonna raise the pressure just a tad. And we're gonna take some tape here. I'm gonna burn the tape a little bit just to be sure. We are going to take this up right here. Take a little bit of white, pack white straight out of the bottle. The good stuff. And I just want to touch up those little spots where the tape lifted up on us. Just really closely, really lightly build it up again. Take it off. this tape right here. Take some of this black here. And we're gonna shade in coming off of this side. Dang, son, it's looking real good. And I guess we could do the eyes. Now, I'm just going to finish off with the corrections of the white. I'm going to come back over here. Can't decide what I'm and how I'm going to do it. I think we're going with tape. Come on. Ah, this tape. All I want to do is take those little overspray marks off. Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah. Chicken from where? Okay.
See that? Ooh, that looks pretty with that all fixed. Look at that. Dang, son, it looks good.
Another animation academy.
Well, I don't know anything about animation, my guys, so I don't know what help I would be to them. All I know is about drawing. But when it comes to animating something, it's a whole different story. Especially nowadays when everything's digital. I mean, don't get me wrong, it'd be a dream to work for Disney, but... definitely hire me to like design their posters or something, or their cover art, something like that. What's up, James Melton? Is it looking good? What do you think? Oh yeah, that's pretty. That looks really good. Dang. Dang, son, did I do that? And let's color in his eyes and I think we'll call it done. I kinda like the white background. It just shows how clean it was. And I don't know how well the red, like, it's just like super red and the yellow too. It's like really, like, with the, I don't know what it is with the lights or something. It looks like really, really red. I've never seen it be so red. Yeah, what was it? What color in the eyes? Okay. I'm not going to add no reduced strip, I'm just going to go straight from the bottle. Oh, you know what? We can't have Lightning McQueen without his lightning bolt, son. What's going on here? Just remembered. Get that blue out of there. We're gonna take some deep blue. good. Okay. Let's get some orange for these lights. It's popping on the white, yeah. Disney gives classes just what I'm doing now? Really? They give airbrush classes? I didn't know that. I wonder if that's even true. Why would they give airbrush classes? Made me forget what I was doing. Orange. Just the drawing part. Well, I can't really take credit for the drawing. What else are we missing? I think. Oh yeah, the thunderbolt. Baby, we could just go get some food when I'm done. What's the ka-chang? Oh yeah, the ka-chang, ka-chang! That's it, man.
I think the only thing that I could add
for James's son.
it looks really good on that white. It looks like it's popping off of that white. Ka-chow! You speak Spanish and don't read me. Oh, I missed it. Sorry. No sé, no sé yo si deberías de conseguir pinturas candy. Eso sería algo que tú deberías de saber, yo no sé. Maybe some starbursts on the paint. High point flashes, yeah, starbursts. I don't know, man. Y'all want to add, but, like, you see these dark tones, like this right here, these dark tones, and like this, and like you can't really see it, but like these areas where I didn't put black, it's like really popping. I don't know. Maybe I could put these in. Put those in. Sure, let me put those in. I don't want to put much over the candy because I think it's going to take away from the red, the super, super red. You know, but I do think this will just be good just to make it a little bit more detailed. I feel like if we put too much over the red, it's going to start taking away from the red a little much. Valencia School of Arts. Disney hires 10 graduating students to join once a year. Just feeling I should get in. I think getting in Pixar would be much better. Yeah, honestly, if you make it either one of those, you're probably good for the rest of your life as long as you keep at it. So yeah. Yeah, I think that's pretty dope right there. Those little white details on the hood, that kind of set it off, these little things here. That looks pretty good. And it is, it's just like, because the canvas is so white that it's like just popping off the canvas. Like really nice red. I could go in and add the highlights and stuff, but I mean, I don't know, man. I feel like we're going to take away from it more than we'll be adding at this particular piece. I don't know. Awesome and fast, he says. Oh, yeah. Yeah. If you just joined, it was fast. I just finished. Yeah, I'll leave it. Probably look at it tomorrow. See if I maybe want to add something to it. Maybe I'll tape off here and add his name in the back or something. I don't know. But I just like that. Yeah. So... check this out. Now I got this. Oh yeah. Make sure you join up. Make sure you hit like. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you join the Skull Squad for more. And look at that. Now we're on this camera. Oh snap, son. And I still look kind of dark even though the lights are on me. But I can get this camera kind of out of my face, I think. So there you go. Hopefully you guys liked that video. As always, thank you guys all for the support. Thank you, James, for sending those canvases. I don't know if you noticed, but this canvas is actually bigger than any of the canvases you sent. We used one of the big ones just for you, buddy. And hopefully your son likes it. Hopefully it hangs in his room. And I wanted to give him something he's proud to hang in his room. I didn't want to just, like, you know, a Cars thing real quick.
And I want to give you something to go in there and look at and be like, whoa, that's pretty cool, you know. Stuff you can't really notice on stream, maybe you'll see it in person. Like the shimmer on the paint. Like, you guys can't see that on the stream. You guys just see the red, but if, like, you go around with the light, like, the red all has a shimmer kind of coming through that looks really cool, so. As always, thank all you guys for all the support. Gracias todos por ver, gracias por el apoyo. If you're watching in Spanish, se están viendo en español. Gracias por ver, gracias por todo el apoyo. Denle like, suscríbanse, todo eso. ¿Qué más? No sé qué más. Answer your questions real quick before we get away to go get some food. You know, as always, we've been stuck in a quarantine, so it's just cool to talk to you guys in the chat. We haven't got out much today. We spent like 2 hours in the backyard today talking with the grandma and looking at a car we're gonna fix, and yeah, and my hands are covered in paint, I just realized. So as always, Lunalox, John Diekman, thank you, Stephen Ward, thank you, Air Todd, James, super thank you, Willie Simirina, saludos, RC Rue, thank you for coming in, Dan Grove, Steve Gish, Paul Tarchala, yeah boy, and then everybody else, RC Rue, Rob Martin, everybody else that came through in the chat, thank you all you guys, we hit over 100 messages today, so you guys rock. We'll see you guys in the next stream. There's going to be a new video dropping probably tomorrow or the next day on how to airbrush real fire with the Candy 2.0. I'm probably going to shoot that tomorrow sometime and then edit it together and drop it. If you want to be on top of the game, if you want to make sure you watch that video first, make sure you go down below this video over here on this side somewhere. There's a join button. Make sure you click that join button. Get on the tier where you get early access and you'll get that video 30 days ahead of anybody else, ahead of everybody, all the regular subs. Only the Skull Squad get it first for 30 days. So yeah, we got quite a few more videos coming in, another airbrush review coming soon. Yeah, we'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you guys again for all the support. We'll see you later. Later, my friends! Look at that view. That's a really nice view. Thank you guys all for watching. Have a good night, everybody. Later.